Hi there! In this video, we are going to discuss Pell's equation, the bane of many mathematicians and students across the world for centuries. Alright, so we're here. And what is Pell's equation? Pell's equation is x squared minus d times by y squared, and that equals to 1. Well, how can that be? Of course, one of the most rudimentary answers that we can come up with to fulfill this is going to be 1 and 0. But this is arbitrary, and we do not ever want to use it, especially when we're trying to solve for further sequential solutions to this problem. So what can we do? Well, let's talk about that. If we have a 3 here, this is just going to make it a little bit easier for within the arithmetic itself. If we have this 3 here, we can reformulate this entire equation here after we get our first answer, which is going to be 2 and 1. Yes, 2 and 1. And with this, we can have 1 times by the square root of 3. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this and put this into a square root radical, turn this into a 3. We are going to add our 2, and then we can simplify this to be something like a. We'll just say a. A equals 2 plus the square root of 3. Now, when we want to solve this for the next sequence, all we have to do is add an exponent to a, which then causes there to be an exponent on our little expression here. So what we can do is then FOIL it. So 2 plus square root of 3 times by 2 plus the square root of 3. And FOIL, of course, so first we're going to end up with 4 outer, so FO outer. So we're going to end up with 2, but we're going to have 2 of these because these are the same, so we can just say plus 4 square root of 3 and plus also a 3, because 3 times by 3 is going to be 9, and the square root of 9 is going to be 3. So we can just lose this radical altogether. We take these two because they can be put together. They are of the same type. So we end up with an answer of 7 and 4 for our next step in the sequence. And we can test this in the formula. Go ahead and try it at home in your notebook. All right, so for the next one, we're going to do the exact same thing. Just remember that our d here is always going to end up in the square root, so don't get confused if the 2 is the same as another number within the formula. 3 and 2 for this particular one. So what we can do is, just like before, we're going to take the d, the 2, we're going to take our y, a 2, and we're going to take our x, a 3, and we're going to say that a equals 3 plus 2 to the square root of 2. And if we square that, what we're going to have to do is FOIL again, just to walk through it. So 3 plus 2, 2, and then again 3 plus 2, the square root of 2. All right, so FOIL first, that's going to be 9. And then we need to go to outer, 3 and 2, that's going to be 6, the square root of 2. But what we can do here is instead just mark it as a 12, because we have 2 of the same brackets. So just that's going to be a 12 here. Try to remember. All right, so we can say that outer and inner are done. So then we need to go with last. So 2 and 2 is going to be 4, so that's going to become a 2 times by 4. So that's going to be an 8. So we already have our 12 for our second answer. 12 to the square root of 2, and we can just get rid of that for our bracket, and 9 and 8 makes 17. All right, so 17 and 12 is the next sequence within x squared minus 2y squared equals 1. So what can we do about our cube? So with our cube, we are going to take a cubed equals 3 plus 2 to the square root of 2 cubed. So we already have 17 and 12 here. Instead of trying to figure this out again for the first two, because you can only FOIL two brackets at a time, what we're going to do is, we'll just do this here. So 3 plus 2 square root of 2, and then we are going to take our answer, 17 plus 12 to the square root of 2. We're going to do our first. 3 times by 17 is going to be 51 plus our 2 times by 17, which is going to be 34. 34 to the square root of 2 for our inner, and our outer is going to be 36. Square root of 2, and our 2 times by 12 is going to be 24 times by 2. So that's going to be 48. All right. So our a cubed for this variant is going to be 99 plus 70, square root of 2. And our next solution in the sequence is going to be 99 and 70. So if you take 99 and 70 and you plug it into x squared minus 2y squared equaling 1, you will get a 1. All right, thank you very much for your time. And as always, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and ring that bell. Whether you like it or not, ring the bell. Do it now. Bye.